Vicky, and it is that time of the month again for January favorites. I'm really excited for this time of the month just because I gather and make lists for you guys of things that I love, and I want to share it so bad. Sometimes I want to do like a favorite even before I could do like a favorites video, but then I want to kind of save it so that I have a whole bunch of stuff to share with you guys. Hank is down here, as you guys can see him. And then behind me, I'm kind of zoomed out so I can show you guys. I'm pretty much almost done with my painting back here. And so this was something that I have mentioned in a few of my videos, that I was working on a Sesame Street along with a Pooh Bear and an Eeyore over here in my painting that I'm giving as a gift to a girlfriend who's having her baby shower this weekend. So Hank is here, and I'll let you guys know why he's here and why he's so excited. But I do want to get started, and I do want to share with you guys some of my faves for the month of January. So one of my first products that I want to talk about is something I'm really, really excited about. And hopefully Hank does not whine all too much. And again, I'll let you guys know what it is that I have here that he's so wants to get to so badly. But the first thing, I'm really excited about this. I really thought this was kind of something that really wouldn't work. I always feel like these products are kind of a gimmick. Like, I'm not really sure if they're gonna work, but I'm always willing to try them regardless. So what this is actually a hair fertilizer. Oh, and I got Hank's hair in there with me. I'm gonna zoom you guys in so you can see the label. I picked this up at CVS actually, and what it is, it's an organic root stimulator hair fertilizer that helps to strengthen and nourish weak and damaged hair, enriched with a blend of herbal extracts to add moisture to dry hair and scalp. It will help create the perfect environment for hair to grow stronger, giving you healthy, beautiful hair naturally. So I found this actually at CVS, and it was in the hair aisle, but it's kind of a consistency inside. So I'll zoom you guys in so you can kind of see what this looks like. It's almost got a mayonnaise-y type of texture to it. It's very thick. So what I kind of do with it is I put my fingers in here, and then I put it all on my root line, and I kind of just separate my hair and use my fingers to kind of put it through the roots. And then what I do is I do take like a wide tooth comb, and then I comb it kind of through my hair. This I was so surprised with, because yesterday I didn't have my extensions in like I have today, but my husband was like, "Do you have your extensions in?" And I said, "No." He's like, "Your hair got really long." And it really did feel like it kind of got longer. So either I had like a growth spurt with my hair, or this stuff has really been working. I've been using it the whole month, and I put it in every other day. Going along with hair care products is the Wen shampoo. And I shared this in a haul that I just had, kind of a random collective haul. This shampoo is actually really neat, and the directions tell you to use 30 to 40 pumps for longer hair and 60 to 30 pumps for shorter hair. Heck no. I cannot use more than like 2 pumps to 3 pumps. It makes my hair so greasy if I use more than like 4 pumps. No joke. I used this because I was thinking, well, I won't use like the 16 to 30 pumps, but I will use maybe like, it tells you in the directions to kind of separate your hair and do it in sections. So what I did was I did like 2 pumps for kind of like the top and front portion, and then in the back and the lower ends, I actually did another 2 pumps. It is way, way too greasy for me, for my hair. I have very fine hair, and I have shoulder length hair. So for me, honestly, you guys, I use like 2 pumps, and it works for me. It is not, it doesn't make my hair greasy. Otherwise, it looked great when I came out of the shower. I blow dried my hair and it looked nice. But then by the end of the night, my hair was like a full on grease ball. When I use the 2 pumps, that works. And I'm sticking to that in January. And it's the Benefits Hervana blush. This blush is absolutely incredible. I will zoom you guys in case you haven't seen it, which I highly doubt. I'm sure you guys have all seen this. See, the blush has gorgeous, gorgeous swirl of color. It's just incredible. It is very, very pigmented, but it's just the right amount of pigmentation. It gives a gorgeous pink color. I actually do use the brush that it comes with because it's angled, it's soft, it kind of just fits my cheek perfectly. And I absolutely love this. I have not used any other blush this entire month. This is all I've been using. The scent in this product is just incredible. I actually have this blush on right now. I just love it. I love the scent of it. I love the color, the texture of it. It is just incredible. Benefit has really done it with the Hervana. My other favorite, and I've talked about this, I've done a video about it, I've been super pumped and super excited, it's the Maybelline 24-Hour Tattoo, these little color tattoo pots. These are absolutely incredible. I love, love, love these little pots. They come in a great little container. The container looks as though it could possibly be made out of glass, so it looks very nice, and it has been compared to the MAC paint pots. And I would say that definitely it could be very well a dupe for the MAC paint pots because the texture and the longevity of these is just incredible. I have three of these. This is the toughest taupe color. I chose my favorite color out of the bunch. I have the bad to bronze, I think, and then the white one, which I can't remember the name. But look at that pigmentation. It's incredible. It is absolutely gorgeous. It is just something that I can't get enough of. I've been wearing this every single day. The pigmentation of this is incredible. I can vouch for at least 12 hours for sure. It does not crease, it does not budge, it does not move. It is incredible. You can apply this with your fingers, you can apply it with a brush, however you'd like to apply it. I have lately been using this all over my lid and then putting satin taupe kind of in the crease to enhance this beautiful color. And I absolutely, absolutely love it, love it, love it. I probably will pick up the other colorful, the bright colors once spring and summer are around. I just think it is just an incredible product. Maybelline really did a good job with these. My other favorite comes from Tarte. I feel like as though I have a Tarte favorite almost every single month. I think Tarte just does a really, really good job with their products. I know they have a new foundation out I have not tried yet. Maybe it'll be a favorite, I'm not sure. But this has definitely been a favorite. It's the Tarte Emphasize. It is an Amazonian clay waterproof eyeliner. It's just a gel liner, and again, it comes in like an acrylic or glass. It's a very, very similar color to the MAC Black Track Fluid Gel Liner. I really, really like this formulation though. It is very, very easy to put on your eye. It stays very hydrating in the little jar and along with being on your eye. The color does not fade throughout the day. It is truly waterproof. I do wear this on my waterline and have not had issues with needing to reapply it. I do use the brush that it came with. I purchased this at Ulta and it came with this brush. It's a double-sided brush. It's kind of got a smaller, almost shader brush that's great. And then I use this brush to apply it. It's just a regular, Sigma has kind of the same gel liner brush, and this is actually dirty from me using it this morning. But this is absolutely incredible. I really kind of disregarded this brush when I first purchased it. I used it once and thought, I'm not a huge fan. But I've recently kind of discovered this brush and have really truly enjoyed it, and I'm already showing it. It's the e.l.f. Powder Brush. This I picked up at Target. What I love about this brush is that it is extremely dense and it's a stiff brush. It's very soft, but it's very stiff, so it holds its shape really, really well. But what's great about it is that when you're applying, I use this to apply my foundation, and when applying foundation, this puts a perfect airbrush kind of a look to your face. I have not had that with my Sigma foundation brushes. I have not had it with really any other brush, kind of the amount of coverage that I get when I use this brush. I recently, like I said, rediscovered this because honestly, I completely disregarded it. I think it was $3 at Target and I totally disregarded it because I thought, oh, it's so dense. Like, what am I going to use it for? You can't really use it for a blush. But honest to goodness, I don't like it for powder. It is totally not something I like for powder, but for foundation, for some reason, especially if it's a liquid foundation, this perfectly buffs it out. So I use the NARS Sheer Glow. I've used it with the Revlon Photo Ready. Staying with kind of makeup things is mascaras, and I believe I've mentioned these before. These are for sure favorites. I've done an entire video on this. It's the L'Oreal Telescopic mascara. The wand of this is just incredible. I do like the formula as well, but the wand kind of has that torture ball on there, and I love that. This is like a newfound discovery for me as far as mascara goes. It just really helps me. My lashes are very straight. My lashes are long, but they're so straight. I've been fighting them for years to try and get them to curl and to hold a curl, and this helps me capture every single lash, because even if I use an eyelash curler, I still have a hard time getting in there with a mascara brush like this one. I have a really hard time getting in there with just a regular mascara wand, but with this little torture ball, incredible. It's absolutely amazing. I also like to use the Lancome, the Hypnose Doll Lashes. I really like to put that on top. So I put two coats of this one and then a final coat of this, and it holds my curl. It does a really, really good job. I really, really, really love the Tarte, the Lip Surgeon's little lip glosses, lip pencils. I'm not really sure. These are really, really great. I got the set, so it came with like five of them in like a set, and it was around Christmas time that Tarte kind of came out with these. It was $29 for all of them, which is great because these are, I believe, full size, and you get five of them, and normally one of these is about $22, I believe. These look like a big crayon. As you can see, it's got a crayon tip, and it can go up, and it can go down. This goes on super easily. So as you guys can see, I've just applied it on my lips, and it gives you a great pop of color. It's really easy to apply, easier when I'm not talking. But it gives you a great pop of color. It smells good, tastes good, and it also gives you kind of a minty feeling on your lip. These Lip Surgeons by Tarte, they're incredible. The formula is not drying at all. I don't even need to feel like I put a lip balm on before putting these on. I just throw this in my purse, put this on. I've got a pop of color. It's hydrated, looks good. I absolutely love it. I cashed in on a reward on my Sephora order. And so I just have a small version of this, or a small one of this, but I've just placed another Sephora order, and I ordered the large one, and this is the Jack Black lip balm in black tea and black. This is just absolutely incredible as far as lip balms go. It is very hydrating. It smells, tastes phenomenal. There are different flavors or scents, however you want to refer to them, but I absolutely love this one. It's the black tea and blackberry, and I love this. I'm getting my full size one soon, hopefully, and I just adore this for your lips. Something that I have from Lush, and this is phenomenal for your little spots that you need to get rid of. So if it's your time of the month and you get a pimple or two, this is actually great. And I believe Ingrid, Miss Glamorazzi, had mentioned this in one of her videos, and I went to try it because I'm always looking for a great spot treatment. This is unreal. It's called the Grease Lightening Tea Tree Cleanser. What you do is it's a spot treatment, so you just put it on wherever you're having that issue. And I'm not kidding you, if you put it on at nighttime and it's a red bump, it is pretty much gone the next day. It's incredible. In here, there are, they say that it's their super effective tea tree and witch hazel gel to clean acne-prone skin and remove oil. Apply with clean fingers. So this works great as a spot treatment. And again, Miss Glamorazzi, Ingrid, had mentioned this as a spot treatment. I tried it. It's phenomenal. I absolutely love it. It's helped me so much with my face. This I got in my Birchbox, my January Birchbox. It's the Zoya Nail Polish. This is in the color Megan. I love this color. I love this formula. It's absolutely incredible. I just put in an order for more Zoya nail polishes because I think they're just great. They're really top notch. This color is beautiful. It is like a purpley, kind of a grayish color. It's just gorgeous, and it's part of their winter collection, I believe. Along with nail stuff, I have two things that I swear by, you guys. I absolutely swear by these products, and I really, really hope that you try them because I have thin nails. I have a hard time growing them long, and they actually will peel. Now, I've had this nail polish on for about 3 days, and the only combination that really works for me is these instant artificials, and this is something I found by Salon Sciences. It's something I found at Sally Beauty. So this is absolutely incredible. It's a pink formula, and as you can see, I've used a really a large amount of this product already. I use this as a base coat, and I put two coats on, and what's awesome about this is it actually feels like it forms an artificial nail on top of your nail. So your nails are incredibly strong. I don't know if you guys can kind of see that on camera. I have never ever, and I'm not even exaggerating, have I been able to grow my nails this long. Honest to God, you guys, I have not been ever able to, or if I do, they will completely peel, crack, and break. These are very strong, so even if I scratch my skin, they're very strong and they don't break. Like, I have not ever had that in my whole entire life. It holds. Other favorite, and I talk about this all the time, it is the Out the Door top coat. This is absolutely incredible. This is my third bottle, and what's great about this, I was a huge fan of the Sachet Beat, but the problem was is I kept running out about halfway, and then I had to throw away the bottle, and it was $10. This little guy, I found this at Target, I found it at CVS, and I found it at Sally Beauty Supply, and it's about $5.49. This is the most amazing top coat I've ever used. I've used Essie's, I've used everybody's top coats. This is incredible. It dries within 2 minutes, and it doesn't bubble, it doesn't peel. It's just absolutely, sorry, I have my pink like coral pants on. I know. Anyway, so now I have a few things that are not necessarily beauty related. So if you don't care, then you can turn this off. I swear by these, live by these. I have everything in these, and they're moleskins. If you don't know what a moleskin is, they're actually a like legendary notebook that supposedly all the greatest writers and, you know, artists have used these notebooks. These are absolutely incredible. They come with all different kinds of colors. I have pink ones, I have red ones. They come with different paper textures. This happens just to be a regular paper texture that's lined, because this is just a notebook where I write all my notes about beauty videos. I use this as my daily like diary for work. I use it for my watercolor drawings. I use it for my ink drawings. I use it for everything. I absolutely love these notebooks. Books. I love my Nook. This is a Nook from Barnes & Noble. The case I purchased from Target. And the reason why I love this case is because it closes on all four sides. It's cute. There's a website, and I'm sure there's plenty of them, where you can download like wallpapers. So when your Nook is sleeping, you have like different pictures. And then when you press the button down here, it slides with your finger, and then you have your book here. I'm currently reading The Maze Runner, but what I want to share with you guys. The book that I absolutely loved in January is called A Discovery of Witches, and I'm showing it to you on my Nook. This book is absolutely incredible. It's written by Deborah Harkness. What I love about this book, you guys, is that I fell in love with the characters. This book came out in 2011, and Deborah Harkness does an incredible job. It is a vampire book, but it is not like the teen vampire books. It has nothing to do with like the way that the Twilight books were written. Absolutely not. It has more of an adult twist on it. The characters are extremely lovable. The story is so well written. I'm actually reading it for a second time. So I read it in January, and I'm reading it again because I actually miss the characters. It's really well written. The story moves very quickly. It is about witches and vampires, but it's more on an adult level. I don't want to spoil anything for you guys in the book, so I suggest you pick it up. It is truly not a letdown. The second book is coming out in June, and I cannot wait. Like, this is just a phenomenal book. The second book that I read in the month of January is the 10th book in the Pretty Little Liars series. If you're not a huge fan of the Pretty Little Liars, or if you've never heard of the Pretty Little Liars, it is a series of books. This happens to be the most current one, the 10th one. It's called Ruthless. It is about girls that kind of get harassed by this girl that they call A, and I just cannot spoil these books for you. There is an ABC Family show. It has nothing to do with the books. The story is totally different on the show than the books are. I am a 29-year-old person, and these are definitely young adult books, if not like junior high books, but I love the stories. They're very easy reads. They're only about 230 pages, so you can moved through them very quickly, but the story is good. It catches me, and I am a sucker for it. I love them. This is a really great book if you want to try a series, which I love series. I'm a sucker for series books, and that's probably why I really like them. These stories are really cute. They're well written. If you like beauty, fashion, and makeup, and all that good stuff, that is in these books, and that kind of is what draws me into them, and that's why I love them. So those are my two favorite books for the month. I also had mentioned that Hank was in here whining about something. I want to let you know what Hank's favorite of the month is, and it's these Vitality chicken breasts with flaxseed and vitamins. Now, I did a review about Pet Flow, and they didn't have these on their website. I find these at Target, and that seems to be the only place, although I don't go to PetSmart and don't go to those places, but I do find these at Target. It's about $15, and my dog absolutely freaks out. Like, he will do a backflip for these. It's my last favorites. They're actually the bracelets that I have on, and I found these two bracelets on Etsy.com. Etsy.com is a great website if you haven't been there. It is kind of a crafter's paradise. So people who have excellent crafting abilities, they're on there. So you can find like iPad cases that people make, iPhone cases. I find a lot of jewelry on there. I love the jewelry because I think they're unique pieces and they're really well put together. And here are the two jewelry pieces that I have on. So obviously not these two. This is actually a Coach bangle, and this is a Tiffany & Co. Bracelet. But these two are gorgeous. I absolutely love these. I'm going to take this one off so I can show you how beautiful this is. This was, again, on Etsy.com that I found this, and I just put in a cross bracelet. I can't remember the person, but it's like a beaded bracelet, so it just fits on with the elastic band on there, and then it has a beautiful cross with a gold lining and really pretty diamond kind of a look in the inside. Obviously, they're not real diamonds. I don't even know if they're Swarovski crystal or not, but I believe I got this for $23 on Etsy.com. Love this little bangle, and I'm gonna undo it so you guys can see what it looks like. So you can see that it's like a little bangle, and what it does is it's like a little belt. How cute is this? I think I got this for like $5 on Etsy. And the little clasp goes down into one of the little holes, so it looks like a little belt on my wrist. How cute is that? Again, I found this on Etsy. I believe I put in like a belt bangle or a bag. I love your comments, you guys. I absolutely love them. I can't get enough of them. Even if you guys just say, you know, nice video or hey or how's it going, I love it because I feel like I get to hear from my friends, from you guys. So those are my January favorites. If you did a video, please post it below. I'd love to see it. Even if you didn't do a video, maybe comment and let me know some of your favorites, because I'm always in the market for new stuff, and I want to know what's your favorite for the month. So please share with me, and I'm sure I will see you guys soon. So take care. Bye.